So here comes Xu Chen and Ma Jin. Number two seeds from China. And up against the Thai pair here of Suket and Sarali, who it's felt this pair are probably the best bet to win Thailand their first ever Olympic medal in badminton. And I suppose they showed that with their opening win against the Taipei pair of Chen and Cheng. Plenty of experience in the Olympics between them for Xu Chen and Ma Jin. Well, they only played their first match of the group last night against Go and Chan. Came through that. And then Chen and Cheng tomorrow night. It's a fairly new partnership, Xu Chen and Ma Jin, but it's been pretty prolific already. This will be a really good match.
Heads or tails? Heads called. Heads called. And it is tails.
Margin.
Margin, sir?
Yeah.
Sorry?
Sir, first margin.
You receive. And which side? This side? Thank you.
Well, Xu Chen and margin. This is Ma Jin, the gold and silver medal winner at the World Championships in 2010. And world champion in mixed doubles with Zheng Bo. Now obviously with a new partner here in Xu Chen. They do have very bright yellow shoes on, don't they, the Chinese players?
I was just thinking the exact same thing. I think, gee, they stand out.
You could turn the lights off here at Wembley Arena and you'd still be able to see them. But this is going to be an excellent match because you've got a former world number one pair in Suket Prapakamol and Sarali Thoungthongkam, and you've got a pair that are good enough to be world number one right now in Xu Chen and Ma Jin, just ousted by their compatriots of Zhang Nan and Zhao Yanlei, who are the number one pair, the pair that, well, they've lost to more than any other pair because they've only been together since 2011. And their form has been absolutely brilliant since they've come together, which is why they've already got to number two in the world. And as I say, it's going to be interesting to see how this one goes. It's, I think, I mean, no disrespect to Go and Cham, the Malaysian pair, and to Chen and Cheng, who many thought would go, if you're going by the seeds, and go on and get through. But I think Suket and Sarali have already beaten the Chinese Taipei pair, have shown that they're probably going to be likely candidates. So in a way, this is a group decider, although not officially, of course, Peter.
No, I think you're right, though. These are the two class pairs in this group who look like they're in form, and look at the results on the board already, and both playing very confidently. Suket and Sarali, they've got great experience, been around for a long, long time, but from the match they played the other day, they played superbly well.
Chen and Cheng 21-15, 21-16. China expects that if there's one discipline where they haven't been completely dominant, it's been the mixed doubles, Peter.
Yeah, look, and I think this is their opportunity this time around to switch things around, but gee, they've got some good opposition they're up against. Interestingly, Sarali, she's a four-time Olympian in mixed doubles.
Yeah,
she's the only competitor in badminton in the mixed doubles to represent at four Olympics.
Yeah, most appearances in the field. Pole Robert Matoisiak is also in his fourth Olympic Games, but of course, as you say, in this discipline, she's the first to ever play in four, and her partner's not short of experience either. This is his third for Suket. So, yeah, plenty of experience between them.
And the interesting thing is the mixed doubles didn't come into the Olympics until 96.
That's right, yeah.
So in 92,
ladies and gentlemen,
wasn't.
On my right, Xu Chen, Ma Jin, China.
Chen Hancock from Great Britain is our umpire. Plenty of Chinese fans here. You see
on
a few flags.
Coach Sompol.
Yeah, a little bit of tension there you saw from him. This should be a fascinating clash. Definitely the Chinese pair the favourites, but great talent, great experience from Sukhet and Saradi of Thailand. Xu Chen So, 6'2", towering figure at the back of the court, so much power. A few symbols showing which way they're going to serve. It's interesting they should do it with symbols, because you know, here they are, they've got a chance to talk to one another. Of course, they're facing a Thai pair. I'm not sure how great their Cantonese is, but I suppose they do come against their compatriots on a number of occasions in tournaments worldwide.
Yeah, I think it just comes down to the doubles pair too, and how they feel comfortably about doing hand signals, or they can just talk, turn around and whisper to their partner. And, I'm sure 9 times out of 10 their opposition aren't going to hear them.
Sukhet and Saradi, they have won a Super Series event this year, which is one of the big events on the badminton circuit. And of course, these pairs have met before. In fact, this was the All England final of last year, which Xu Chen and Ma Jin won. What a group this is, though. I mean, you've got world rank 2, 5, 6, and 7 in it. I mean, how do you feel being the world rank number 7 in this group and being the outsiders?
It's tough, isn't it?
Which is what Go and Chan are.
It just shows the quality. But it's great having the round robin system now. It gives the players more than one chance. Plus, it gives the spectators an opportunity to see the players out there more than one time, too.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. I think it's not usual for badminton. It happens in other events like Commonwealth Games and that.
But usually that's in the teams events,
yeah.
Whereas the individuals,
sure, that's right.
A lot of the time it's just knockout, which makes it pretty tough. You work for 4 years. Sometimes you come up, you know, like we've got here, you can be in the top 10 in the world and come up against someone who's ranked 4 or 5 places ahead of you.
Seen some great dignitaries here at Wembley Arena, haven't we, Peter? Peter Charles was here the other day. Who did you say was here this morning?
No, he was here the other day.
Did you forget him there as well? Was he? I think it's probably Princess Margaret,
yeah.
It's been great, some of the players introduced to some of the dignitaries, and I think everyone so far has certainly been enjoying the London 2012 experience. But for these pairs, it's business. These are medal hopes. And interesting, I mean, you've got a Xu Chen and Ma Jin. I'm not sure how much you've seen of them, Peter, but what makes them so good? Obviously, you can see the big man at the back and the springy girl at the front there.
Yeah, obviously, look, he would be the big power hitter at the back of the court. Looking to set up for Ma Jin at the front of the court. But having said that, imagine a guy of his height and he's fully committing himself to the front court as well. That could be quite intimidating for any opposition.
It is incredible, obviously, we know China have so many players available to them. But here, Ma Jin, you know, she was a women's double. She was partner of Wang Xiali. Then she loses her partner because she's off to Wu Yang. But she gets another shot at it alongside Xu Chen.
It's incredible the depth of talent that we've got.
And she was a world champion with Zheng Bo. He gets dropped.
Yeah.
And then she's with Ma Jin. Ah! She's just old-fashioned racket there. 5-0. Start of this opening game. I think whatever the result here, I think both pairs will be confident in their abilities to get through to the last 16, and no disrespect to the other pairs who I've mentioned already are pretty highly ranked.
Yeah, look, both these pairs, I suppose the other thing too is they've got to win on the board, so you know, that builds their confidence, and even if they drop this game, they know that they are in form and they're playing well.
So and if it goes according to ranks, Group B, who will face the winner of that group, could well be Pedersen and Fischer, Denmark. Again, that's not set in stone.
There's that drift at the back of the court again. Well judged. Sampol is a great national player, played for many years on the circuit, a national hero in the game of badminton for Thailand.
Well, they come here in good form, these two, which is why they are thought as a good hope for medal. They won the Indonesian Open Super Series event, which was in the last month or so. And I'd say, given the fact, I mean, a lot of pairs are turning up here for the, you know, their first Olympics, and they've admitted to being nervous, but when you 32 like this man, Suket known as the magician. 33 like Sara Lee, who's playing in her fourth Olympics. And you've been there, you know what it's about.
And I think that's the strength of the combination too, is the experience playing with one another as well. They know each other's games back to front.
This is their third Olympics together as well.
And that, you know, builds a lot of confidence, is that you know you can rely on your partner 110%.
And got to the quarterfinals in Beijing. And of course, a win here would book a place in the quarterfinals again. Very tight start, but this is, you know, a chance as well for the winner, not just to win the group and then maybe have easier opposition in the quarterfinals, although that might not necessarily be the case, but a chance for you mentally to, you know, especially for the Thai pair, if they can beat one of the top Chinese pairs, that will, you know, give them the biggest of lift going into the rest of the week.
Oh, it certainly will, and you know, make their opposition that much more wary of them as well, because if you could start knocking off the number two pair in the world, then you're going to be looked upon as one of the invincible pairs. Yeah, that's a good serve.
10-8.
Excellent serve. Must have just got the outside edge of the line.
But yeah.
Great deception on the flick.
It's interesting in how in badminton, say compared to tennis, of course, you've got the same disciplines in tennis, mixed doubles, women's doubles, men's doubles. The doubles are very much seen as the inferior tennis, if you like. But in badminton, it's much more equal, isn't it?
Oh, it certainly is. Look, people look at sometimes as the doubles events, as the blue ribbon events, in as a spectator's sport, because it's just so quick with the rallies and the combinations of play. So there's a lot of respect for the doubles and mixed doubles in badminton.
Well, it's nip and tuck so far.
You couldn't get any closer for the first game.
It's the Chinese pair that take the very narrow lead into the interval here, 11 points to 10. lacking really from that opening exchanges that suggest who is going to dominate here.
Now it's very good controlled play by both pairs, and we were talking about before the first three strokes of the point set up everything, and you could see how tight they were placing those shuttles to the side of the court.
This is their last Olympic bash, 4 years' time in Rio. Well, it'll be respectively 37 and 36. Glad to see them doing it then. You never know. Not sure what their plans are.
Well, they're certainly enjoying themselves at the moment. They've had a lot of success in 2012. As you're saying, the Indonesian Open, also champions at the Swiss Open, the World Grand Prix. So with that sort of form, you wouldn't think that they would want to retire too soon.
Put away as well by Saralee.
Yeah, good consistent attack, and once they're on it, the front court, they need to keep applying that pressure, which they did.
I have to say, she's probably as fit as she's ever been. She's lost quite a bit of weight, Saralee. She's looking in there. Good form, obviously good fitness.
Yeah, she's playing so well at the moment, and she can really open up this game.
The deception there.
And she can be the key player here in this mixed doubles match. She's got a lot of talent. And
she feigned to hit it, and then...
Yeah, he's wondering whether she had enough reach, but she kept moving. Just following the line of that shuttle. Making sure that you're in the right position to time it well enough. But Saralee, she's got a wonderful serve. It's consistent, keeps low to the net, and she can really put some pressure on the opposition just through her consistency at the front court. Look at that. Lovely flattening out. It's a great example of it. It's an important part of the game.
And if you wonder why we call them Suket Saralee, obviously it's very common in Thailand for the first name to be used, which is sometimes a real relief because the surnames can be pretty tricky for us to handle. Many of the Thais actually in sport have nicknames. I'm not sure. Maybe that Suket's known as the magician. Not sure what Saralee's is. Magician-ess, maybe?
I reckon not the close. That was an important point there for China because... a two-point margin, gets out to three, then it gets the pressure on. We're midway through this first game.
You can see the tide, they're very relaxed, aren't they, out there. They are looking like they're, it may be a swan song, they're going out to enjoy it, and they know they're in great form as well. What a lovely position to be in. I mean, having beaten Chen and Chien, Chen and Chen, the Chinese tie paper in straight games as well, will be... They can't coach during the points, can they?
Not during the rallies.
They can in between points?
They can have a word as long as they're not distracting the opposition. They can't have a little chat from the back of the court. It has to be within the rally, after the end of a rally, not during. played. That's a great thing about Suket and Sara, really. Don't get too over anxious. They're just controlling the shuttle, keeping it down. Bringing their opponents forward. You can see that desperate dive there from Xu Chen. Well, dragged him out of position, didn't it, with the nice little block to the front court. That's what you're looking to do so you can set up for the kill. Well played again by Sara Lee. A lot of responsibility for her at the front of the court.
Never been more than 2 points in the game, has there? And the back level pegging at 15-0 here.
That's the pressure on the front court. Keeping the shuttle low and flat. Well, she's got to lift it deep, but
it's a fine margin, isn't it?
It certainly is.
It's one of the hours of training afoot. Second nature, really.
Sara Lee was doing a lot of the work at the back of the court there. And Thai pair, that's where they really don't want her to be. They want her at the front, dictating the play. Clever play from the Chinese. Forced errors there.
And suddenly, a little bit of daylight for the Chinese pair.
Just overplaying that shuttle. It already dropped below the net.
First in this one. Oh, has it hit the line? It has, you know.
It's a wonderful shot. Very, very deep attacking point to finish it off.
It's okay, who blinks first or who goes for the big shot?
He's gone for it here.
She's good.
Yeah, lovely shot. Just what the doctor ordered.
Not within 2 points. Getting hot. It's Wembley Arena when you're playing these kind of rallies.
And that's where she needs to be. She needs to be at the front court so she can intercept and play that sort of rally. play again. Just controlling it from the back of the court, keeping the shuttle down.
3 points in a row, one just in time. Got the concentration there from Xu Chen, stretching and reaching.
Brilliant shot.
Turning on the star.
And you could see there, Suket was just talking about keeping up and keep that presence at the front of the court, indicating to Sara Lee that's where she needs to be. They're lucky to get out of that one, but what a wonderful cross-court lift.
Claiming she hit the net.
Yeah, hit the shuttle on.
Well, what a call that
is. Yeah, just at the top of the net.
So she has to.
Got to wait for the shuttle to cross the net. She can't reach over.
Interesting if we do get a replay of that. Yeah, but that's a big call. Would have been game points. She's looking up at the big screen, I think, there, just to see if it was going to come up, but it hasn't. Probably just as well, really.
You've got to go with what the umpire.
The umpire's right there. She's got to.
She's in the closest position to see it. So.
Now it's game point for Xu Chen and Ma Jin, and what a crucial point that could be at 19-0. Wide, and well, controversial call.
Well, a tough call. I don't know about controversial, in that I'm sure the umpire made the right call, but
yeah,
a tough one.
No, quite right. Spot on there, Peter. It was a tough call, and as you say, probably the right call, and it proved a decisive one as well. Because Xu Chen and Ma Jin take the opening game, 21 points to 19. But great entertainment, wasn't it? And I think a little sign of things to come over the next few days, because this is a potential medal clash, this.
Yeah, I definitely agree. You know, for Sara Lee, it's that was a tough thing, because she's doing the right thing. She's coming up close to the net. She's putting the pressure on. And hopefully she doesn't become negative and fall back from that experience. I'm sure she won't, because these guys, they've played a lot of matches over the years. They're tough competitors.
Yeah, and they're not in knockout here. Yeah, there's no guarantee that they'll win their final match. Going Chan, who cannot go through there. Suket and Sara Lee's final match. Xu Chen and Ma Jin take on Chen and Cheng of Chinese Taipei. That'll be tomorrow.
Love.
let's get away from them quickly here. Xu Chen and Ma Jin are the sort of pairing that once they get the bit between their teeth, they're hard to stop. I mean, they're only, as I say, formed in their partnership just over a year ago. Second tournament together, they won the All England Championship. Not too bad, is it?
It's not a bad way to start a combination, that's for sure.
They also won the China Masters last year and lost in five other finals this year. They've reached two other finals and won the Korean Open. Runners up at the Asian Badminton Championships the last 2 years as well. They're always there or thereabouts.
Well, we've got a great start here now. Five love. Good play. Sukit at the back of the court, just keeping in the control. And picked up a couple of points. That'll give him some confidence. Really rattled by that last couple of points, I think, in the first game.
Yeah, it can be demoralising. You know, it was a shot that Sara Lee would expect to make, and she thought she'd made it. You know, the rules are the rules. You touch the net before it's crossed, and you don't take the point. And from thinking she had a game point, suddenly it was game point to the Chinese.
Drift out the back of the court. You definitely can see the contrasts of ends.
It's difficult as well for the organisers to, they'd like to eliminate it completely, but of course you can't have it boiling hot. I mean, the weather in London has improved as well over the last week or so, from the rainiest June in over 100 years to a very wet July. It's turned almost into summer over the last couple of weeks, not in, just in London, but across the United Kingdom. And you do need a little bit of air conditioning.
Yes, who would have thought that would affect a indoor sport like badminton, the weather outside, but it's quite warm in the stadium, especially with the TV lights as well. And when you get a capacity of crowd of over 6,000 people here at Wembley Arena. Bit of luck there for Sara Lee.
Yeah, most of the players, I think, are staying in and around Wembley at the moment. If you know your geography of London, this is in northwest London, obviously right by Wembley Stadium, which is adjacent to Wembley Arena, and the Olympic Park, where the athletes' village is in Stratford, which is in the east of London, which is only probably about 12 miles. But you can imagine the traffic in London, even though there are Olympic lanes, it's not simple necessarily to get from Wembley to Stratford comfortably and quickly. A little bit of a gulf so far in the second game, isn't there?
Yeah, they're really starting to dominate from the front of the court. Chinese pair. A little bit of sting has gone out of the attack at the front court from Sara Lee.
And you have to wonder, the longer the game goes on and the more the Chinese are in dominance, you wonder how much, of course, the Thai pair will be thinking of the next match they have to play, even if it is just subconsciously. Because, of course, they to make sure they're fit and ready and raring when they face Go and Chan tomorrow.
Yeah, that's very true. I'm sure they're still giving 100%, but
subconsciously, yeah.
Creep into the mind that, well, I've got a very important match tomorrow as well.
I'm sure they talked about these sort of things as well with their coaches.
Yeah, a straight smash and then being through the center to finish it. Xu Chen, he's a big man. Got a lot of reach, hasn't he?
Yeah.
There by Suket. Great variation down the line. Creating the short lift. Well put away. In a lot of trouble there. Xu Chen.
To match the venue, the Thai pair. Tops for Thailand.
The red and gold stands out brilliantly on these courts as well, doesn't it?
To 10-8.
Yeah, they certainly have picked up the pace here. And Suket just controlling at the back of the court, keeping the attack. Not overplaying the shuttle. Setting it up nicely. Good run of serves too by Sara Lee.
Points to 8. And of course, a game up as well.
Well. They seem quite relaxed and in control, but be careful. The experience of the Thailand pair, they can turn around very, very quickly. Narrowed that margin by 3 points.
Xu Chen and Margin closing in on the last 16 here. But giving a good run for them, Alec. Great action shot there. Xu Chen in action.
He's put everything in the action up. Sara Lee off the front court and get it to the back court. That's where they win their points.
Oh. short.
13-9. Great variation. Nice drop to the front court, sitting at that point. Stretch there just to get back into the rally. Look at him, full stretch again. Comes up with the goods.
Brilliant play from Xu Chen. And it keeps the tie pair at arm's distance in the second game. Brilliant again from Xu Chen.
Yeah, he's bringing that shuttle down really well. Great elevation on it. And, trying to draw Suket into the front court.
If, of course, Xu Chen and Ma Jin win this, and then say Chen beat Xu Chen and Ma Jin, and Suket Sarali won, and it was they're all level and wins. It's head to head, so Suket and Sarali. Between them and Chen and Chen, obviously haven't beaten them, and they would go through. And if it's all too difficult for them to complete, then you have to go on number of games won, then points won. Thankfully, we haven't got to go our calculators out to shit. Some wonderful rallies in the first game, not so much in the second one.
And again, the shuttle going long. It's going to be very, very long road back from here.
Yeah, especially against the. A pair as formidable as Xu Chen and Ma Jin.
Oh, lovely shot.
Nonchalant, wasn't it? Made it look so easy. It wasn't. A little flick of the wrist and another point on the board. 2 points away from victory. And it's match points already. Again. Ooh, went for the line, just missed it. One match point saved by Suket and Sarali. It's out, it's long, and it's Xu Chen and Ma Jin who book themselves a place. Surely then into the last 16 of these Olympic Games. Two wins out of two for them. Suket and Sarali of Thailand will still have hopes. Yeah, 21-19, 21-12, the first game tight, and especially at the end, some a tough call given that swung it China's way, and well, the second game was a very different affair. So Xu Chen and Ma Jin win this match in Group D, and are very much in control of the situation. Confirmation of the score then, 21-19, 21-12 in 41 minutes. The number two seeds take the victory.